Hello friends, good evening. Welcome one and all to this another episode of Miraculous Mondays, aka Management Mondays. So today's topic, as you all know, this is based on the case study. So before I start on the topic, of course, I'll be waiting for a few people to join in and just let you know why I started all this. You can say from last Monday onwards, or rather from the first week of this new year onwards. This is my endeavor to give back to the society in one way or the other, along with my WhatsApp groups that majority of you are a part of, which are running since 4 years now almost. So this is my endeavor or an experiment or a trial setup for the next 6 months. As I said, for the 26 episodes till 30th June, every Monday, every Thursday, I'll be there. Mondays would be Management Mondays or Miraculous Mondays, and I'll be discussing on practice management topic or a medical legal topic, a short one for 15 to 20 minutes. And on Thursdays, I'll be dealing on any of the topic of finance. So what exactly is my aim? My aim is to distill you or instill some amount of fresh information in you with fresh ideas to set your mind on a think mode so that you can imbibe new ideas and let your subconscious mind work on them. So the formula is simple: to give you maximum information in least possible time. I have not kept a fixed time of 8 o'clock because, as I said earlier also, when we have a fixed webinar once in a month, twice in a month, then we can fix up the time. But to do it on a routinely basis, sometimes we don't get free till 8. So for getting free at 8, I have to manage my patients sometimes till 7:40, 7:45. So it becomes a hurried kind of a thing. So I don't want to do injustice to anyone. So I've kept this time between 8:15 and 8:20. So I'll be live during that time, as I was during today session also at around about 8:18, I was live. So yes, initial 3-4 minutes I'll be discussing before I divulge on or jump onto the topic so that I allow a few friends to join in. So as I said, the Mondays and the Thursdays will be a regular feature for the next 6 months till 30th June. The only condition when these will not be happening on the designated day would be either a celebration in my family or a festival holiday. So this Thursday, there is Lohri in Punjab, a night festival, a day and a night both festival. So this Thursday, there will not be a thunderous Friday, a thunderous Thursday, but it will be a fantastic Friday for this week only. So just to let you know in advance, of course, I'll repeat the same in the end. So I'll be seeing you after this on Friday evening at 8. Of course, Friday is again a festival in many parts of India, Makar Sankranti, but then it is a day festival mostly for most. So I'll be there on Friday for the finance session. So let's come back to, you can say, today's session. I hope many of the colleagues must have got notification now. And as people know me, I am on time. If I have said 8:15, 20, I'll be there on time. So let's begin the proceedings and let me just share my screen. And of course, many of you know the topic for today. So it feels great, you can say, to be a part of the same case study for many, many of the individuals. So welcome, friends, officially to the second episode of Miraculous Mondays or Management Mondays, in which we'll be discussing practice management and medical legal aspects and ethics. So this is episode or week number 2 of the 26 designated first half of the year. So let's begin. As usual, always my presentations will begin with thanking the Lord Almighty, who's given me much more than what I deserve. And this is my brief CV. Many of you must be wondering what gives me an authority to speak on these topics. I am, apart from being a dentist, I am a triple MBA in 4 specializations. I have a marketing management from Annamalai, a dual in HR and finance from IGNOU, and a hospital management in IIM from IIM Pune. Apart from them, a host of PG diplomas. So many of you are aware of this. So let's begin. So this was a case study which I put up in the WhatsApp group in the morning as well to just give you a preview of today's topic, which I'll try to give you, of course, on the morning of the session when it is happening. So this was a case study given to me by Dr. ABC. Of course, the identity has been kept discreet for the obvious reasons. But what I would want you to take home is, without knowing the identity, just try to assimilate or just try to have the message below that. So the colleague, him or her, just for the presumption purpose, we presume it is a him. So I have an 11-year-old practice in metro, in a metropolitan, with a workforce of 7 people, which includes doctors, assistants, and 2 receptionists, and 3 visiting consultants. So 10 people to manage. The clinic has a fair amount of footfall, and any person who is employed is trained well to be helpful in any category, is trained well to be helpful, concerned, and empathetic towards the patients. Wonderful approach. I have a negative problem. According to my spouse, who is also a dentist, of getting over-involved with the staff, in a way, pseudo-adopting them. This was the problem which was given to me by Dr. ABC. Then the case study by Dr. ABC continues further. Apart from the salaries, which are good as far as the market rates are concerned, along with the perks and gifts regularly, and every second month clinic dinner, outings, and since the clinic works on Sundays to Sunday lunch is in clinic, and they do have a weekly off. The thing where I feel that all this backfires and they get over involved in the finances, which I don't know how to keep that away from them. Yes, in bigger setups, we all know the collection is done by the staff usually. So the receptionists who take care of the billing and all are seen discussing with the assistants. Daily work done, and every now and then one or the other demands an unfair increase in salary. The story further continues. Collection of payment from the patients directly by me. Of course, I did not give a solution. This was the problem, just you can say, put up by Dr. ABC. So by me is not possible in this present working format. I dread that the ongoing things may go into turmoil because of my fear that hiring a new person may or may not be a good decision, because a known devil is better than an unknown monster. The fear of the unknown, we all know that. So I want your advice in how to decategorize this and how to keep them away from the finance part, as it is exceptionally stressful the way staff tries to take advantage and manipulate you. It is mentally demoralizing that your whole energy is diverted from work to a dilemma whether to massage their ego or give in to their irrelevant demands. So I replied Dr. ABC the same day only. It was given to me, I think, on Tuesday, last Tuesday. So immediately on replying, I requested the colleague, I requested Dr. ABC, since the doctor was known to me, to make this as a topic for my next case study or the next episode of Miraculous Mondays. Dr. ABC immediately agreed, only on the condition that if the identity is kept, of course, I said that is a given. The identity will not be disclosed, not in the city. So let's forget that. I've given the solutions already, but I still wanted Dr. ABC also to attend this and watch it, because many things which I might have given in the solution in the written format sometimes don't convey the mindset of the, you can say, the solution giver. And I do not vouch for that I am the perfect solution giver. I always believe that we all can have multiple ways. I'll be giving you multiple ways to deal with this situation also. But the point is, which way suits you, you have to pick yourself. Of course, I will give my way also out of the most common possible solution. So let's go on. Let's get straight on to the point after this sharing of information for the initial time period. So we all know it is, you can say, these are the few pointers before the solutions. We all know in bigger setups, in metropolitans, this is a very common problem with clinics with even a decent footfall, or even the clinics with a massive footfall. And this has actually taken an ugly turn after the, you can say, 2 almost full years of COVID-19 now. Till December, we used to say last year COVID aaya tha na, March mein. So now we know it is almost 2 years. Just you can say a couple of months, we are far away from the original lockdown, which locked India in the month of March 2020. So money is the new god. Money is the new god. Of course, it still was, but money has become the new god. I fail to think why this is happening, but this is there. Everybody wants money. and the values are going for a toss. And this does not hold good only for staff, but for our own fraternity also, but for our own, you can say, colleagues also. Many a times I might be ruthless, but yes, I need to convey a few things which is there. But let's come back to the original solution or original problem. Staff may not be greedy in that sense. They may be actually demanding an equal contributor. They may deem themselves that they are equal contributors and may be expecting a share by demanding more salaries. Because one of the commonest reasons, staff is not aware of the exact cost. They only look at the direct cost. They see what we all know. I'm not going to share here. We all know what a crown costs directly from the lab. What they fail to decipher is the material cost, the overhead cost, and the other indirect cost. I hope many of you have seen my costing videos and you believe that sometimes the indirect costs are 66%. If your direct is 33, indirect is almost sometimes double. So, and not for all, but for some procedure, of course. For some procedure, it is 50-50. Some procedure, it is 1/3 and 2/3 vis-a-vis the direct ones also. So you need to understand that, unfortunately, many of the colleagues were not aware of the costing part. I would say thank God for lockdown that I devised those formulas and shared with the colleagues open-mindedly. I never wanted to keep them a secret about certain things which I devised in the first and the second lockdown. The first lockdown, I had a charges raised up formula devised based on the 80-20 principle, and the second lockdown, the costing ones. So many colleagues were not aware. So how can we expect the staff to be aware of the exact cost? They only look at the direct cost, which are paying to the lab, and the revenue being received from the patient or what we are charging from the patient. They know, they just see the relative difference of that. And then another pointer may be that the staff sometimes start feeling indispensable. Hum hai, to doctor hai. Doctor, hum nahi hai, to doctor kuch nahi kar sakta. Over-dependent sometimes, but they forget one thing. Nothing stops in this world without anyone. Nothing stops in this world. This world is a fast-paced world, even double fast-paced than what it was pre-COVID. Nobody even cares to think. Somebody dies, it is just a RIP and move on. This is the new commercial world. And I won't mince any words in this. We all are so much bogged down in our daily settings. Again, not shifting away from the topic. Let's come back to the original topic. But yes, I've given you a few points to ponder. These may be the various reasons. These may be the various pointers. Now, let's come to the directly solution part. What will you do? What are the possible solutions? Number one, Hitler ban jao. Nikal do sabko. Sab nikamme hai saale. Sorry for the wrong word. Fire everyone. Start afresh. Shuru se shuru karo. Trust me, staff training is one of the most difficult tasks. I lost my two staff members to COVID. Of course, not by death, but by relocation or by other reasons. I know how difficult it is to train staff. It is very hard to find a trained staff. So becoming a Hitler might not be actually possible for people with multiple staff members where there is a system and a culture being followed. Then refuse flatly by saying nothing. Give a free hand. Salary to badhegi nahi. Jahan jana hai, chale jao. Politely, of course, main to salary badhaunga nahi. Jana chale. We let the, you can say, the feeling of angst develop into them. Some people may react badly. Of course, people mean staff here. Some staff may react, you can say, resign to their fate. Yeah, ye to badhayega nahi, ab kya karein, aur to kahin milegi nahi. Then the third, show them their place by an aggressive outburst. Unko unki aukaat dikha do. I'm just telling, don't get me wrong. I'm just telling the possible ways. Colleagues have been doing it because I have been doing a lot of SWOT analysis, a lot of PGAs, practice growth analysis. I know the mindset of many colleagues. So these are not my solutions. I'm just giving you the possible solutions, how the mindset of a doctor or a dentist or even any entrepreneur for that matter works. Show the staff their place. Ki tum minions ho, we are the boss. Really? That is the reason I put this thing here. I always say this thing in my practice management workshops. The staff is the right hand of a dentist. The lab is the left hand of a dentist. इन दोनों के बिना डेंटिस्ट बिना बाजू का डेंटिस्ट है, बिना बिना सिर्फ धड़ वाला डेंटिस्ट है. यू कांट वर्क विदाउट आइदर ऑफ देम. यू रन, यू सर्वाइव, यू फ्लरिश विद बोथ योर आर्म्स एंड दोज आर योर टू आर्म्स. सो नेवर गेट इनटू दिस फीलिंग, जस्ट अग्रेसिव आउटबर्स्ट, गुस्सा आना, एवरीथिंग. एंगर मैनेजमेंट इज अ वाइटल थिंग. यस, एंगर इज अ नेचुरल इमोशन. I won't say that something is being happening unnaturally over here, but yes, we should know how to control our anger, or at least if you have done the outburst, you should know how to get back to normalcy immediately. Then the fourth way, this is a line, of course, by default only, but then this was an aggressive way. By chance, the next three are the conservative ways of dentistry, as we say. So do a team meeting, explain the cost, especially overheads, very politely. Beta, ye direct cost hai, ye indirect cost hai, ye overheads hai, ye expenses hai, ye hai, wo hai, wo hai. Inka kya result hoga? That will be shown you in the next slide. Then be diplomatic. Thoda thoda karke karte hain kuch, koi baat nahi. Is mahine le lo 200 zyada, 300 zyada, 500 zyada, 1000 zyada, whatever. Karte hain kuch, koi baat nahi. Some people are extremely diplomatic. I really want to follow that trait in some matters, at least, if not all, because I normally am a totally no-nonsense person. I don't, you can say, tolerate diplomacy. But so this is not my cup of tea. But then this is the way also to react. Then the sixth way to react, again, it would be wrong, but then I have to say, like the Punjab government, as they say, continue to ignore by giving one excuse or the other. Khajana khali hai. हमने ईएमआई देने हैं. कुछ भी पंजाब पे खर्चा आता था ना, टिल 3 months बैक, टिल कैप्टन अमरिंदर सिंह वाज द चीफ मिनिस्टर, खजाना खाली है. मिस्टर मनप्रीत बादल आर ऑनरेबल फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर, खजाना खाली है. दिस वाज हिज फेवरेट वर्ड. एवरी पंजाबी नोज दिस. 4.5 साल हमने यही लाइन सुनी है, राइट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट डे टिल द 4.5 years. एंड सिंस मिस्टर चरणजीत सिंह चन्नी बिकेम द सीएम, मनप्रीत बादल इज द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर स्टिल, बट एंटी इनकम्बेंसी बहुत हो गई है. नाउ अब पता है कि सेंसिटिव पॉइंट है, अब ये ब्रेक कर जाएगा. तो अनाउंस फ्री सोप, फ्री बिजली, फ्री पानी, फ्री रेता, फ्री केबल, फ्री एवरीथिंग. एज दे से, देयर वाज अ व्हाट्सएप फॉरवर्ड. अ स्कूल बॉय कम्स टू हिज फादर एंड आस्क, पापा बैग फट गया है मेरा, नया ले दो. तो द फादर सेज, खजाना खाली है, लाइक मिमिकिंग द पंजाबी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ कोर्स. द बॉय who is an 8-9 year boy replies, फिर चन्नी वांगू ऐलान ही कर दियो, means please announce it like our current CM. Of course, no disrespect intended to anyone, it is in the lighter vein, just because elections are around the corner, so everything is being announced free. When you have a NRI case at your anvil, or we can say lined up in the next week, announce free soaps. कोई बात नहीं, इस हफ्ते सबको double मिलेगा, सबको खाना यही मिलेगा, सबको perks मिलेंगे, whatever. You can also announce like, दो ना दो बात की बात है. पीपल डू इट. आई नो ऑफ माय वेरी नोन डेंटिस्ट शेयरिंग द सेम लैब एज मी एंड हिज पेंडिंग इज 2 lakh rupees टू द लैब. एंड आई आस्क दैट गाय, द लैब ओनर्स ब्रदर हु समटाइम्स कम्स टू मी, इज इट लोकल लैब, आई मीन, 2 lakh कैसे पहुंचा? सर ऐसे ही है, 30,000 बिल बनता है, 5,000 दे देते हैं, कहते हैं मेरे को ईएमआई देना है, मेरे को वो देना है. सो ही इज लाइक अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ 5 and 6. तो अगले महीने फिर 40,000 बिल बना, तो फिर 10,000 पकड़ा देंगे, ऐसे बन गया. अब क्या होता है, अभी 20,000-30,000 दे देते हैं, फिर बोलते 2 महीने बाद आना. सो द साइकिल गोज ऑन. देखो ऐसे तो 2 लाख हमेशा क्रेडिट में रहेगा. सर मैं भी बहुत परेशान हूँ. तो तुम काम कितने दिन बाद देते हो? यू गिव द वर्क टू मी इन नेक्स्ट डे और मे बी 2 days or 3 days. व्हाट डू यू गिव? सर मैं भी दुखी आ गया हूं, आई डोंट गिव वर्क टू देम फॉर द 15 days. सेड हाउ डज द पेशेंट रिएक्ट? सेड उनको कोई परवाह नहीं. हो कहते पेशेंट को पहले ही बोल देते 15 दिन बाद भरेगा काम, बाहर से बन के आ रहा है. पीपल डू इट, बट दैट इज द वे पीपल ट्राई टू डू इट. नाउ सी द अप्रोचेस, बिकम अ हिटलर, रिफ्यूज फ्लैटली, और बी वेरी अग्रेसिव, डू अ टीम मीटिंग, बी डिप्लोमैटिक, कंटिन्यू टू इग्नोर, खजाना खाली है लाइक अप्रोच. एंड देन if you are a politician, as per the last 6 points, you would hate this Mark Twain quote. So number six is out of the window now. So we all know politicians and diapers should not be changed or should be changed very often. And for the same reason, we all know. I don't need to say. I didn't say it. Mark Twain said it. So now, if you were the first approach, do you want to be labeled as a Hitler? When you say refuse flatly, do you want to be labeled as insensitive? Or when you are, you can say anger filled, you can say, are you being labeled as khadus? Or if you try to explain them the costing part in the boardroom meeting, do you want to be labeled as a pakau entrepreneur? Or if you thoda thoda karke karte hai kuch, labeled as a diplomat? And the last I told you, do you want to be labeled as a politician? So you need to understand what exactly you want to be labeled as. Because we get offended by any of these words. But then, kuch toh log kahenge. Logon ka kaam hai kehna. It does not mean whatever action you do, there will be actions and reactions. There will be repercussions. There will be a point where you will not feel it. So it does not mean that you stop acting. So what do you think is the solution? And why I'm asking you this? Because I believe I'm a very professional person. Tough situations demand tough decisions. And don't let that label thing get into your head. कि मेरे पे मैंने ऐसे किया तो मैं ये कहलाऊंगा, ऐसे करूंगा तो वो कहलाऊंगा. वो चारों तरफ कुआं या खाई तो रहेगा रहेगा, कुछ ना कुछ कुआं खाई गटर नाला कुछ ना कुछ रहेगा चारों तरफ. Whatever way you want to go. So don't get that label thing get into your head. And when in Rome, think like Romans. Professional space means be professional to the core. Even if it involves ruffling a few feathers. You cannot please everyone, even in your home, who are your blood. You cannot expect to do the same in your professional space who are not even related to you. Because ultimate aim is professional space, hai, professional banna. Ultimate aim is business profitability. And I do not mince any words in saying that dentistry is a business, because at the end of the day, where income and expenses are involved, it is a business. Yes, we are into a noble profession of treating people, all said and done. At the end of the day, we file our, make our balance sheet, we show our profits, we file our income tax return based on our profits or our income. So it is not a noble thing. It is a profession and a business primarily. Income tax ki schedule mein bhi na, schedule BP likha hota, business slash profession. So we have to understand and respect that. So professionalism in the workspace is required to a great deal, to a great extent. And always try thinking outside the box. Try to think outside. I've told you six possible solutions, not solutions exactly, six possible ways how people have reacted or will react in such a situation. Thinking outside the box means try to creatively think in new ways rather than the usual or the expected way of thinking. My idea may not seem totally to you outside the box, but I always try to do the same in majority of the cases. And my solutions sometimes seem unconventional, but they are not impractical at all. As I said, they might seem unconventional to you. So I'm going to give you the solution which I gave to Dr. ABC. So my first thing was that please don't think that you'll be impractical. You'll be practical. And to my surprise, as per my today morning's feedback, Dr. ABC has already started acting luckily on my technique. Luckily. Now, how does it pay? Only time will tell. But then the first thing was, I told Dr. ABC was, please don't be a Hitler. I was about to say Dr. Hitler. Sorry, Dr. ABC, I didn't mean to say that. But I meant to say was, please don't be Hitler or change all your stuff. That is for sure. So put all your fears to rest. So in Punjabi, mein kahawat hai ki agar doodh dene wali gaay, I'll be saying in Hindi, then repeating. Of course, the translation is before you on the screen. Doodh dene wali gaay thodi pagal ho jaye, to usko bhi tranquilizer deke thoda sa rest karwate. Pagal in the sense, not literally, but it you can say thoda sa jaise bolte na, nasha ho gaya us tarah. kind of thing. It also needs tranquilizers, and which means that the cow will be sleeping. After the rest, it will wake up fine. But that would mean that we may not have a milk for a few days. But it is better to lose a milk for a few days rather than eventually losing the cow to madness. And tab to gaay bhi jayegi aur doodh bhi jayega. Abhi sirf kuch dinon ke liye doodh ja raha hai. So I always believe staff, as I said, staff is the right arm of the dentist. You may be ambidextrous, you may be a left-hander, but I mean to say that you are the right hand. So staff should be nurtured always, but then a fine line should be drawn. What Dr. ABC you are doing is good. You have been nurturing them. You have been over-caring and over-supportive. Nothing wrong in this approach. But if the staff also reciprocates the gesture by overworking or paying you back in kind, of course, they won't pay, give you cash back. But of course, by overworking or by going small, little, simple things to please you, just to make you happy that yes, our boss is so considerate, so you can say so kind enough to acknowledge our shortest possible needs. But then here the situation is not similar. The staff is not reciprocating back. They are taking advantage of the situation. Probably you are soft and they are taking you for granted. That is the bottom line. And I told Dr. ABC that these are COVID times and everybody looks towards more money. They don't realize the other side of life. Sorry, not life, where people are jobless and even searching for jobs just to make a livelihood. They sometimes get a feeling of being invincible, indispensable. I told you, nothing stops in this world for anyone. I strongly feel all your staff is not bad and only one or two apples who is spoiling the whole lot of seven people. So my recommendation is to forget about the bad apple for the moment. Forget it. Ki kaun hai, search karo ki kaun bhadka raha hai, kaun kar raha hai, kaun kar raha hai. Jiske haath mein cash hai, pehla shak to usi pe jayega na. Jo payment receive kar raha hai. Let's forget that. Just pick up the weakest link amongst the staff. The one who works the least or on whom your dependency out of seven is the least. Put the same guy or girl, whatever, on notice period. My guess would be, what I guessed from Dr. ABC's situation was either of the two receptionists. Because they would be the ones sitting majority time together and gossiping and spreading the bad word. Finances, I mean here. And no wonder one of them may be the bad apple as well. But before you pick up the weakest link or the one whom you have the least dependency, what are you supposed to do before taking action? Keep an accountant, a new person, preferably a him. No gender bias, but yes, I have my own reasons. And please don't get me wrong in any case of this. Preferably a him who handles the billing part. And ask your current reception staff to train him for billing. Yes, that would mean paying an extra salary for a month or two for eight people, not for seven people. And an accountant is not hard to find. A trained staff may be hard to find, but an accountant is not hard to find in today's times, especially. Once you feel he's trained enough, execute the above. Of course, the notice period part, I mean to say. So that is the way I suggested Dr. ABC to proceed. Also, I suggested to draft out a new policy, which is incentive-based, work more and take more profits. I always give example of Dr. Rajat Anand from Mysore, who has this system in his practice. He has a disincentive and a good incentive practice. They get rewarded and they get their incentives cut also. Do a mistake and get a deduction from the profits. The basic salary still remains the same. That does not get a deduction as per my way of approach. Of course, Rajat also does the same thing. So stop the freebies, random perks and gifts. Always, you can say, award on the occasion. Whenever somebody performs well, employee of the month. Accept the Sunday lunch. Don't stop that. If you're making them work on Sundays, you can say, which is a must. You may be giving them a weekly off, but don't stop the Sunday lunch. Stop the weekly offs and put it on incentive as well. Whosoever comes, get a day's salary extra. But those who don't, won't get a deduction. Basic salary, agar 5,000 hai, toh wo 5,000 hi rahegi. For example, it is 200 rupees per day. For example, somebody wants to forego his weekly off and comes on that day also. He gets 5,200. Somebody performs well and incentive is, let's suppose, awarded at 200. He gets 54. He commits a mistake. Out of that 200, 100 is deducted, 53. I'm just giving you an example. The basic still would be take home. If 5,000 is there, that 5,000 would stay put. It will not be deducted even in case of an offense. Even in case of an offense or a disincentive thing, I would say. So that is, the basic won't be there. At least people get motivated that chalo basic to mil rahi hai. But the feeling is when seven of people are competing each other, not for the same place, but for the common target. The common target is incentive. So when they are competing for the same thing, they will know. Haan, hum karein. Isko to, agar hum saare 5,000 salary pe hain, yaar wo 58 le gaya is bar, mereko 51 hi mila is bar. I need to buck up my socks and work harder further next month. So this is a competitive spirit being inculcated. And you are not doing anything extra. You will see your efficiency automatically improved by incentive approach. When staff works better, the output and productivity improves and enhances a great deal. So make it feel like a business. If you are in the workspace, you are a professional, you are in a business, make them feel. No more of family culture. I never encourage this thing in workplace. Rarely, except for an occasional get together where I'm not the boss. Otherwise, I don't advise to, you can say, go in for a family culture kind of a thing. Be a no-nonsense person totally. Professional space demand this and you have to be there, doing that. And workplace means work and no gossip. Put gossip and unnecessary loitering around also as a negative one or a disincentive list. And make sure one of them who you think is the brightest keeps an eye on them, who notices the incentive. And you will laugh at this. It is a funny thing. When they have to guard their, you can say, against their own job, when they're fighting with themselves for their livelihood, their chances of more income via incentives, you will see their loyalty is changing. Surely will not happen overnight, but will happen for sure. That is for sure. Because people change when the environment around them changes. This is the rule of nature. Baki, the next side is self-explanatory. Adi, main pehle bol chuka hun. Kuch to log kahenge, logon ka kaam hai kehna. Hamara kaam hai aise logon ko aur unki baaton ko ignore karke chalte rahe. That is the bottom line. Because I don't mince my words in saying, colleagues, do a bit of more of a family kind of a thing. Yes, when you are at a workplace, it is a rule-based place and discipline and dedication should be the hallmarks of any professional. Now, the final, of course, the carry home gyan. This is one debate I always had with my mom till a few Diwalis back. Even with my wife sometimes. Every Diwali, whenever household maid was given so much, according to my mom, of course, maine usko ye bhi diya, naya kambal diya, naya set diya, whatever. Still, she used to be puffed up. Puffed up means muh phula ke ghoom rahi thi. Agle 4 din wo bas muh phula ke ghoom rahi thi. Until my mom adopted my method, which I advise to many. Of course, I'll be sharing the same with you today as well. Staff does not care about your gifts or incentives in kind, especially on a Diwali, especially or a bigger festival of the year where you, for our Muslim brothers, it may be a Eid. For our Hindus and Sikhs, it might be a Diwali or a Gurpurab. Similar way, whatever way, the time of the year, one time of the year, again, COVID times discounted. The normal time of the year when you reward your staff, some give an extra month salary along with a mithai box, along with a bone china set. They don't bother about those bone china and mithais. दे डोंट केयर अबाउट योर गिफ्ट्स और इंसेंटिव्स इन काइंड. उनको लगता है आपके लिए वो चीज यूजलेस थी, तभी आपने हमको दे दिया, गरीबों को, हम गरीबों को दे दिया. सम पीपल, सम डेंटिस्ट डिस्पेंस मेडिसिन, दे बाय देम. आपके स्टाफ को तकलीफ हुई, उसके मदर को तकलीफ हुई, आपने उनको फ्री दवाइयां दी, आपने जो खरीदी थी. नॉट ऑल ऑफ देम मे बी सैंपल्स, उन्होंने फिर भी कहना ये तो सैंपल था, इनको तो फ्री आया था तो मेरे को दे दिया, कौन सा एहसान किया. आई रिमेंबर अ कलीग, ऑफकोर्स आई डोंट नेम, आई वोंट नेम, आई वॉज डूइंग हर स्वॉट एनालिसिस एट द टाइम ऑफ दिवाली. सो शी, यू कैन से, कॉन्टेक्ट मी फॉर एनीथिंग. मैंने स्टाफ को ये दिया, ये दिया. एंड आई रिमेंबर शी गेव अ बोन चाइना टी सेट और अ डिनर सेट. नया कहते मैंने निकाल के चमचमाता सेट दिया. स्टाफ ने ही सोचना मैं इसको सिर में मारूंगा बोन चाइना को. मैं जहां पे रहता हूँ वहां बोन चाइना एक मिनट में टूट जाएगा. मैं इसको क्या करूं? वाई? ना बीवी, ना बच्चा, ना बाप बड़ा, ना भैया. होल थिंग इज कैट कि भैया सबसे बड़ा रुपया. दैट इज माई अप्रोच, ऑफकोर्स फॉर द स्टाफ, because they will not care for their hard work through this, because as they believe, for example, Diwali or Eid or Gurpurab is their pay time. Whatever you pay them through the year is not important, but what you do then at that occasion surely is important for them. And they only care about one thing, Gandhiji, and nothing else in kind. Of course, money. I always tell my mom, aap bhi paise deke cheez khareed ke laye ho na. Why do you want to, you can say, spend your money on that thing? Give her the money. She needs money more than your things. And that is the thing I always say. Incentive mein cash ko add kar do and see your productivity improving. Ye perks, dinners, get-togethers, occasional, once in a while, I don't mind. Once in a year picnic, it's okay, perfectly okay. Your team culture builds, your bonding develops. I don't deny that fact. But doing it every month, every alternate month, it only, you can say, इस पे खर्च कर देंगे, हमारे को नहीं देंगे पैसे. पीपल हैव दिस नोशन. अगर उनको इतनी समझ होती, आप कॉस्टिंग का उनको समझाने लग जाएं कि ये डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट है, इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट है, अगर उतनी समझ होती तो वो आपके पास स्टाफ की नौकरी कर रहे होते. इमेजिन दिस थिंग. दे मे बी शार्प बट दे आर नॉट इंटेलिजेंट लाइक यू एंड यू बिहेव लाइक डम्बोस इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम. सो इट डज नॉट मीन दैट यू स्टॉप दिस केयर. गांधी जी इज रिस्पेक्टेड बाय देम, सो रिवॉर्ड देम विद ओनली गांधी जी. दैट इज द बॉटम लाइन. This slide is itself explanatory for all purposes for that matter. And but then professional means you should not be totally ruthless. Professionalism means you still have to have those virtues of speaking nicely, politely, getting your work done. It does not mean that you react in a bad way. Main tere ko paise de raha hu, tere pe ehsaan kar raha hu. No. No, you are not doing it. You are paying them for their duty. It is not an ehsaan on them. वो आप पे एहसान कर रहे हैं शायद. सो इट इज अ म्यूचुअल गिव एंड टेक. अगर आप ऐसा सोच सकते हैं तो वो भी ऐसा सोच सकते हैं. प्लीज डोंट गेट इनटू दैट माइंडसेट. ऑलवेज अ बैलेंस इज अ फाइन बैलेंस इज रिक्वायर्ड बिटवीन नर्चरिंग एंड मेंटेनिंग अ डिस्टेंस. नो फैमिली कल्चर इन दिस सेंस. ओकेजनली इट इज फाइन बट नॉट ऑलवेज. एंड अ प्रोफेशनल एटीट्यूड इन क्लिनिक. एंड आई वुड रेस्ट माई केस. आई होप डॉक्टर एबीसी आर वॉचिंग दिस एंड यू गेट माई व्यू पॉइंट वाई आई गेव यू ऑल दोज सॉल्यूशंस. The solutions are the same which I gave to you. I just wanted to convey my mindset to you and to other colleagues who will be watching this video live or maybe later on when this video goes to YouTube. So this is the only thing which I wanted to convey in my lecture today. So of course, I have put you in the think mode. So Jap Naam. I am a Bollywood fan, so these slides cannot be without this thing. So thank you so much for watching. Just a few things before I wind up. This is my YouTube channel link. Go to YouTube and search Dr. Bhavdeep Ahuja or youtube.com/c.drbhavdeep. This is my channel. Already has 400 plus videos, all for colleagues. Majority of them are webinars and short videos. This is my KYC. You can contact me via this. So many of you are not aware. Some contacted me after my last session. I run free practice management groups and finance groups separately for this purpose. 6 group is on. And there are no invite links. I'm the only admin. And it is only a study-based group. These groups will complete 4 years in Feb 2022. So if you want to be added, if you are interested in studying, these are totally advertisement-free groups. Those who are in my groups know it. Even my own workshops are not promoted over there. let's keep commercialism aside. So this is the reason I have been providing free education, spending my own time since many years now into this thing. Of course, the online education started 5.5 years back, but my own group started 4 years back approximately. So my social media presence, the Facebook page where this is happening, and Insta and Clubhouse, all by my name, Dr. Bhavdi. So please do give me your feedback on the Facebook page or on the WhatsApp group or on the YouTube channel, wherever you watch it. Please do give me your feedback. Welcome both BookKits and BrickBats. So thank you so much. And I'll stop my share for question time if there are any on the Facebook page group, or I will wind up the session if there are not any. So let me just check. Hi, Rajat. Hi, Dr. Ramchandra. Hi, Dr. Vinita, ma'am. Good evening. Hi, Shripal. Hi, Bhola. Hi, Deepak, sir. Hi, Dr. Ruchir. Hi, Dr. Kriti. Hi, Dr. Akshay. Hi, Dharam. Hi, Dr. Salima. Hi, Dr. Rajiv. Hi, Gaurav. Hi, Baiju, sir. Any question anyone wishes to ask, or we are done for the day? Okay, guys, thank you then. I'll see you on Friday this time for Thunderous Thursday session. It will be a fantastic Friday since it is a Lohri festival in Punjab on Thursday. It is a night festival and a day festival both. So I'll be with my family on that day, of course. So this time, Thunderous Thursday would be a fantastic Friday just for this week. And if there is any change in the next week events, as I've told you earlier, the same event happens the immediate next day. Thank you so much for watching. Please be there every Monday and Thursday between 8:15 and 8:20 p.m. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a good night.